Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's discuss compound libraries, which are an indispensable tool for hunting for active compounds. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to list three common types of libraries, describe fragment-based drug discovery, and outline the features of DNA-encoded libraries. Traditionally, compound libraries consisted of compounds synthesized in previous research programs. Since these are drug research programs, the molecules tend to overlap with drug-like space, around 30 heavy atoms, and a molecular weight that is often in the range of 4 to 500 grams per mole. Losartan, to the right, is a drug for high blood pressure and fits the profile of being drug-like. It has 30 heavy atoms, that's the number of atoms excluding hydrogens, and a molecular weight of around 420. The level of potency for molecules found through screening a traditional library might be in the 1 to 10 micromolar range. In big pharma, the company collection will have over a million molecules, likely multiple millions of compounds. Often a subset of the full library will be used routinely in the screening. The company library is an important and valuable asset for finding actives at the start of a drug campaign. Fragment libraries contain smaller molecules. Fragments are literally parts of a full drug with molecular weights often in the range of 200 to 300 grams per mole. The size of a library is often around 3,000 compounds, so way smaller than a traditional drug-like library. Because the molecules are smaller, the acceptable potency cutoff is higher at up to 1 millimolar. During optimization, leads from a fragment library need to be grown and expanded considerably to boost potency and other properties. The use of a fragment library falls within the umbrella of FBDD, fragment-based drug discovery. How does this work? To the right is a representative fragment library molecule with a molecular weight of about 200 grams per mole and just 15 heavy atoms. To the left is our drug space. The fragment is not part of drug space, but very many molecules in drug space might contain this fragment as part of their structure. So this one fragment probes the potential activity of all those very many molecules. In this manner, a relatively small number of fragments can effectively sample all of drug space. This is great news for smaller companies, which almost certainly do not have access to a multi-million compound library for screening. DNA-encoded libraries, also called DELs, involve linking a segment of DNA to a library molecule. So the molecule is able to bind to the target in the assay, and the DNA tag is used to identify which molecule has bound to the target. DELs can be absolutely huge, even in the billions of molecules. Because of the way DELs are prepared and screened, the identification stage, often called deconvolution, can be challenging. DELs are a relatively new library technology, and the area is growing and being improved. As an emerging field, DNA-encoded libraries are more commonly used by large pharmaceutical companies, which have the resources to work in the developing field.
We have listed the most common types of libraries used in screening: the traditional drug-like library, fragment libraries, and DNA-encoded libraries. We also gave some additional details on fragment libraries and DELs.
Thank you for watching all the way to the end of the video. If you would, please consider leaving a like or subscribing to the channel. Take care.